Sardar Bhagat Singh admirably said, "May the sun in his course visit no land more free, more happy, more lovely than this our country." Greetings from Sim to one and all present and watching. I, Rachit Tiwari of Class 11, am overwhelmed with reverence to address you all on this auspicious occasion of the 74th Independence Day of our native soil, the land we live in, the land we live for, our India. Thank you for joining us. 15th August 1947, the day when India completed its transition from the annihilated, tortured British India to the independent, democratic Republic of India. This day was also poignantly highlighted by the unfortunate partition of this very terra firma into India and West and East Pakistan, the latter of which is now known as Bangladesh. But it was on the eve of the same day that Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of independent India, talked about India's tryst with destiny, a speech that changed India's course of history. In what is widely regarded as one of the greatest disquisitions of the 20th century, he said, and I quote, "At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom," unquote. Words which significantly reside in all our hearts. Independence Day is not just a day of elation, jubilation, and celebration. It is also very importantly a time when we pay homage to all the luminaries who sacrificed their light to illuminate our lives. The martyrs and the strugglers who fought in arms and with words and whose blood boiled with patriotism. Every drop of sweat spilled onto the ground watered the seeds of Swaraj, and every agonizing wound received brought us one step closer to freedom. They were not just fighters, they were warriors. This struggle was initiated by the likes of Tantia Tope and Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi, who led India in the revolt of 1857. Though this attempted rebellion was inefficacious due to multifarious reasons, it certainly did not go in vain. This inspiring display of gallantry and fearlessness influenced their successors and set the tone for a more organized and tactical uprising. The torch was then carried by the moderate leaders, who, though pleading in approach, provided stability and a direction. They were also the founding fathers of the Indian National Congress, the political organization which would go on to lead India to liberty. The radical nationalists, led by the famous trio of Lal, Bal and Pal, then took the driving seat of a ride full of twists and turns. Their motivational speeches and writings generated an aura of energetic patriotism which engulfed all of India. Such high nationalistic spirits had never been witnessed before. The arrival of Mahatma Gandhi in 1915 marked the inception of an era of peaceful agitation. The phlegmatic, restrained and prudent methods adopted by him took India all the way long to complete independence, which subsequently resulted in him being rightly ennobled as the father of the nation. The current state of affairs in India is not what was desired in the early days of independence. The dissatisfying quality of education, the concerning levels of safety for women, the worryingly hiking number of indigents characterized by plummeting opportunities for employment signify that there is still a long way to go for our nation to be ranked amongst the absolute best in the world. this Independence Day, let us vow to protect what can be preserved, neglect what may be abhorred, fight what must be defeated, and love what shall be adored. Let us vow to make India great. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.